Hello, I'm Dr. Owais, and today I'm going to delve into a topic that has a significant impact on the lives of children and their families: the role of nutrition in asthma prevention and treatment. Let's begin by understanding asthma. Did you know asthma is a widespread global issue affecting over 235 million people, including millions of children worldwide? This chronic respiratory condition can lead to shortness of breath, persistent coughing, and wheezing, making everyday activities a challenge for these young ones. In fact, it's estimated that approximately 1 in 12 children in the United States alone is diagnosed with asthma, and the numbers are similarly alarming in many, many other countries. You know what's really interesting? The way diet can potentially have an impact on controlling asthma in kids. Making changes to your child's diet could either make your child's symptoms better or worse. It's also interesting that there seems to be a connection between the increase in asthma cases and the growing popularity of westernized diets. These diets are often high in unhealthy fats and processed foods, which means they lack antioxidants and have a lot of saturated fatty acids. So it is possible that what we eat could be related to bronchial asthma. A lot of research shows that eating lots of fruits, vegetables, and omega-3 fatty acids can actually help reduce asthma symptoms. It's true. On the other hand, if you eat a diet that's full of processed foods and saturated fats, it could make your child's symptoms worse by causing inflammation. So it's definitely worth considering what you eat when it comes to managing your child's asthma. So, my first advice is consume vegetables daily. Vegetables have vitamins and minerals that are really good for your child's lungs. Veggies like broccoli, spinach, and kale are packed with antioxidants and phytochemicals. These amazing nutrients can actually help reduce inflammation in their lung and improve how well they breathe. Pretty cool, right? Also, did you know that eating vegetables with high fiber content can actually help your child maintain a healthy weight? This is super important for your child's lung health because carrying excess weight can put a lot of strain on their respiratory system. Also, when you include different vegetables in their daily meals, it can actually boost their immune system and make them healthier overall. Next, I want you to incorporate fruits into your child's diet on a regular basis. Fruits, similar to vegetables, have the vitamins and minerals necessary to keep their lungs healthy. Citrus fruits such as oranges and grapefruit, or kiwi fruit, for example, is believed to be good for asthma because it contains a lot of vitamin C. Apples are rich in bioflavonoid called quercetin. I think it's really cool that quercetin has the ability to help reduce inflammation. Fresh and frozen fruits are generally considered better choices than canned fruits because canned fruits often contain higher level of sugar. Also, fruits such as berries and bananas in your child's diet can give them a variety of vitamins and minerals that are beneficial for their overall health. One way you can add fruit in their diet is to offer fruit as a snack or dessert. This can help them develop healthy eating habits early on and provide a good source of antioxidant and fiber, which can support a healthy immune system and digestive health. Another great food supplement that have shown to be beneficial in children with bronchial asthma is omega-3 fatty acid. Fish contains a good amount of omega-3 fatty acids. According to a recent study, it was found that children who consumed enough omega-3s from fish had improved airflow and were less reliant on asthma medication compared to children who didn't eat fish. You could consider adding tuna, halibut, or salmon in your child's meal a few times a week. These fish are rich in polyunsaturated fat, which can be beneficial for their health. Next, you should add more grains into your child's diet. Many children obtain their proteins from sources such as poultry and red meat. There was a study done in New Zealand that found that children who get their protein from whole grain like oatmeal, wheat, are less likely to experience wheezing caused by asthma. Children should aim to consume a minimum of 3 servings of whole grains every day. For breakfast, for example, you can have some whole grain bread with a spread of unsweetened peanut butter. Or for lunch, you can prepare a dish of whole grain pasta with some vegetables. Including whole grains in a child's diet is beneficial for multiple reasons. It not only helps lower the chances of asthmatic wheezing, but also provides important nutrients such as fiber, vitamins, and minerals. Moreover, if you replace refined grains with whole grains, it can help your child maintain a healthy weight and decrease the chances of developing chronic diseases when they get older. Finally, make milk a vital part of their daily diet. Milk can be very helpful to asthma sufferers. It contains high amounts of calcium and magnesium, which studies have shown can help reduce inflammation and increase airflow to help make breathing easier. Plus, milk is a good source of vitamin D, which has been linked to improved lung function and reduced asthma symptoms. Milk is also rich in protein, which is essential for building and repairing tissues in the body. This can be particularly beneficial for children suffering from asthma, as it aids in strengthening respiratory muscles and promoting overall lung health. Now, after speaking about the foods that can be beneficial, let me share the kind of food you should be avoiding for your child suffering from bronchial asthma. Firstly, reduce your child's consumption of carbs. Many children enjoy snacking on carbohydrates. Kids with asthma can be particularly affected by this. When the child consumes processed carbohydrates, their bodies treat them like sugars. This can lead to inflammation in the airways if we consume excessive amounts of processed carbs. Please try to reduce your child's consumption of crackers, chips, cookies, and other processed carbohydrate snacks. You can try replacing your regular breads, tortillas, and pastas with whole grain options. These are generally gentler on your body and respiratory system. Eliminate trans fats from your child's diet. Trans fats are a type of unhealthy fat that can increase the risk of heart disease and raise bad cholesterol levels in the body. They're commonly found in processed foods such as fried foods, baked goods, and margarine. It is important to check food labels for the presence of trans fats and opt for healthier alternatives, such as foods cooked with healthy oils like olive or avocado oil. Now, in the process of digesting these fats, the body produces chemicals that can cause inflammation in the lungs. Trans fats are found in butter, most baked goods and sweets, chips, or other fried snacks, and nearly all fast foods. Avoid serving your child any processed food and keep fast food meals to bare minimum. Less processed food can mean less asthma symptoms. To sum it up, the right nutrition can be a game changer in managing childhood asthma by making informed food choices. You can help your child breathe easier and lead a healthier life. If you found this information valuable, please like, subscribe, and share this video. Your support means the world to me, and it helps me continue my mission to provide essential knowledge about children's health and well-being. For even more expert insights and personalized guidance, visit my website, drawaysrafiq.com. Thank you for joining me today, and stay tuned for our next episode where we'll delve deeper into understanding and managing bronchial asthma triggers. Together, we can empower our children to have healthier lungs and brighter futures.